Have you ever dreamt that, have a dream that just didn't make any sense?
We often have dreams that seem very bizarre, but they usually have another meaning. Dream expert Lainey Dolphin offers the keys to analyzing our dreams in her new book. It's called Dreams Do Come True. And Lainey joins us now in the studio, and she'll analyze some of your dreams. So give us a call now at 312-540-WFLD. But thank you, Lainey, for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
You know, the interesting thing is that we all have these similar dreams. Everyone, when we were in our meeting, said, oh, I've had that falling dream, or I've had, you know, the dream of being naked in front of a whole classroom full of people. Why do we have these similar dreams?
Well, I think the most important thing to say is that although there are some common dreams that all of us have, the dream at the first level is always about something that happened to you yesterday or something that you thought about yesterday. And actually what we're doing is problem solving in our dreams. And so you always want to look at how are you in the dream reacting to the common dream? Like, I've had people tell me flying dreams. Some people tell me that they have to flap their arms so hard to get to fly, and maybe that's a comment about them saying that it's so hard for them to feel good. Or maybe someone else is flying away from something, or are you flying to something? So you always want to try and link, and this is what I do in the book. I make it very easy for you to, number one, link the dream to a specific issue in your life that it's trying to address.
And so number two, hold the key to the,
yes,
the meaning,
you do.
Really.
And you know what you want to do about something. And so the answer to the issue comes to you in your unconscious, of course, before it gets to your conscious.
Now, that's an interesting point you bring up, because a lot of these dreams have certain themes like falling, flying, teeth falling out,
right,
death in a dream, sexual dreams. But you're saying it's not just the act of these particular things, it's what you're doing in each one of these cases.
How are you interacting?
That, for example, the falling could mean several different things depending how you're falling, or if you're falling,
yes,
in control, or if you're not falling in control. And
yes, as a matter of fact, I had the news anchor at Fox in New York City say to me that she dreams she's falling and she hits the ground and she gets up and walks away. And there, you've heard all that,
yeah,
stuff about, mm-hmm, people, if you die in a dream, that you really die. It's so not true. And for her, it's a comment about the fact that when she gets really down, she knows how to pick herself up.
Right.
And so that's what you always want to look at. How is the dream related to what's going on in your life?
Lainey, we have a caller. Becky from Glendale Heights is on the phone. Good morning, Becky.
Hey,
hi,
Becky.
Good morning.
What's your dream?
Well, I dreamt the other night that I received a phone call. The phone call was from my mother, who passed away a little over a year ago. And it was so very real. Mm-hmm. When I picked up the phone, she said, Becky, I want to let you know that we're on our way. We should be home soon. And I was like, Mom? She goes, yeah, the weather looks pretty good. We should be on our way. And I said, Mom, I think you sound so very tired. She goes, I am really, really tired, Becky. And she did. She sounded very tired. And I said, I think you better lay down now, Mom, and get some sleep. And she said, oh, I'm just so very tired. And the last thing I said, you know, I told her, I said, I love you, Mom.
Right.
And she very inaudibly said, I thought she had said, I love you too, but it just kept getting fainter and fainter.
Right, and you mentioned at the beginning that your mom has passed away, is that right?
Yes, a little over a year ago.
Right. And I think that's a really healthy dream, because what we're doing in our dreams is like getting used to something,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm,
practicing. And so that's what you're doing in the dream, is getting yourself accustomed to the fact that your mom has gone away, and where better to practice than in our dreams. It's
okay.
A very safe place to practice.
Wow.
She sounded so tired, though. I would like to hear her as, you know, her healthy.
But, you know,
self
if you're
again.
Saying to yourself that your mom is so tired, then you're also saying to yourself, you're preparing yourself to say goodbye to her or goodnight to her in some way.
Okay, that makes sense.
Thank you, Becky.
Thank you so much.
We have another caller from Chicago. Yeah, V?
Mm-hmm.
Hi, are you on the line?
Yes, I am.
Hi, V, what's your dream?
My dream is an current intercourse with someone other than your spouse.
Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't hear.
She's having intercourse with someone other than her spouse, a sexual dream.
Oh, very good. I have a great example of that, because we use play on words and puns in our dream all the time, and what you're thinking comes in the form of a picture. So very recently, a woman called and said that she was having sex with someone who she would never, ever, ever have sex with, and it felt so good, and it was because, and she felt so turned on, and it was because the fact when you use language like that, that something really turns you on. She had just started boating, and boating was something that she thought she would never, ever, ever do. And she got so turned on by boating. And so when you use language like that really turns me on, or I really got screwed in business, that guy really screwed me. So if you talk like that, the language comes in the form of a picture.
Wow. I gotta
and of course, sometimes you're having a sexual dream because you feel sexy.
And it's just, it's sometimes sex is the thing. All right, V, thanks
sometimes
a lot.
When you eat ice cream really late, I'm kidding.
All right, this is Doug from Westmont. My dream, I was confused about which keeps coming up, is when my neighborhood becomes flooded and I take a canoe out but end up floating away to a canyon where I've never seen.
Okay, and so he's... You always want to ask the dreamer, if I had the dreamer here, I would ask him, how do you feel in the dream? Mm-hmm. Is the flood happening because
you feel
overwhelmed? Or But I kind of like the dream because he starts floating away. First of all, he gives himself a canoe, which I think is terrific, that he gives himself a vehicle to get away with.
Yeah.
And the other thing is that he floats away from the house altogether. So maybe when things are overwhelming, you just know how to get yourself away.
So we're just working out a lot of things in our subconscious that we can't do sometimes in our conscious
state. And the answer is there. And so what you get, you know, the reason why I wrote the book is because you can propel your problem-solving skills if you look at your dreams. And the other thing is the people that come into your dreams are often the solution to the issue. Like, for example, if I have trouble speaking up to my husband, I might dream about an aunt who's passed away who is someone who is a really assertive person, and she might appear in my dream because I need to access that ability that I have to open up my mouth.
Well, Lainey's book is called Dreams Do Come True. You can, of course, go on the web. Our website is dreamsdocometrue.ca for more information. Thank you very much.
Thanks,
There's so
Lainey.
Much to talk about. Thank you, Lainey.
Thank you.